Google's approach to dealing with spammy link building or black hat link building has become really aggressive in the last couple of years. And part of this has been to introduce a manual penalty, manual link penalties or manual actions to deal with and to address websites that are in clear breach of webmaster guidelines. So for those of you who are kind of suffering from some kind of manual penalty, you'll know that it's not always a very easy or quick thing to deal with. There's also a lot of cloudiness in terms of what route you should take to get rid of the penalty. But fortunately, the team at Jellyfish, we've been pretty successful. We've dealt with a lot of these in the last couple of years. And so we've identified kind of what works and what doesn't work. So the link discovery is really the first part of that kind of manual penalty removal process. And I always think that if you fail at this step, chances are you're going to fail in the entire process. So the idea of link discovery is to make sure that you're identifying all of or as many of the links that are consisted within your bat link profile as possible. And only then, once you're confident that you're really looking at the whole picture, can you start to identify what looks to be natural and what looks to be kind of false or negative links. Okay, so one of the biggest problems within the link discovery process is the fact that depending on what link discovery tool you're using, you're going to see different results. So for example, if I'm using Bing Webmaster Tools, I often get a different download of links to if I'm using Google Webmaster Tools or Ahrefs or a tool like that. So for us, that kind of poses the first challenge. So what we do is we take a spread of tools and we download all of the different findings that those tools, all the links that those tools can discover, combine them and deduplicate them. And only then are we relatively happy that we're seeing pretty much 99.9% of the links that exist within a website's backlink profile. Okay, so once you're confident that you've discovered as many of the links within your backlink profile as possible, the next step is classifying them. So marking them as being natural links, links that we want to keep, and unnatural links, links which have been falsely acquired in the past through kind of dodgy tactics. Now, link classification, it sounds like a fairly kind of normal process, but it can actually be quite a hefty task, because I think while we can use tools, you know, link classification tools to make a head start or to break the back of understanding what's good and bad, you do kind of need to run through it manually as well, and there's nothing like a human eye to see whether a link should be there or shouldn't be there. I've got a couple of tips around classification. The first one is to actually be fairly aggressive with what you're identifying as being an unnatural link. So a classic mistake that people make is to try and remove just one or two links at a time to try and kind of tip the balance within their backlink profile, but that doesn't really work. I'd say, look, don't try and play any games, just be completely honest and aggressive with your link profile. If a link looks as if it was unnaturally acquired or achieved by kind of slightly dodgy means, just get rid of it. The second recommendation that I'd make would be that we tend to become very obsessed with in looking at specific metrics. So webmasters will often kind of become obsessed with looking at things like domain authority or the page rank of referring links or referring domains. And I always think while those metrics are kind of key things to look at, you should also just be completely honest as well and just say, look, from a human perspective, irrespective of what the metrics are saying, does this link look natural? Does it look as if it's coming from a decent site? Am I happy that my client would be comfortable with the link coming pointing to their site from a site like this? At the end of the link classification process, you should hopefully have a list of links which are great, which you want to keep, and also a list of links which you definitely want to remove, you know, unnatural links. The things I'd typically look at would be links coming from really low quality directories, links coming from completely unrelated websites, from article farms. Those types of links are always the ones which are going to get classified as unnatural. I think also looking at Web 2.0 websites, which you're getting links from things like footers and blog rolls, that's often seen as very suspicious. But the biggest area for me, which is an absolute telltale sign of link manipulation, is exact match anchors. So it's something which Google has talked a lot about. And for me, if I was to give you one, you know, one area to really kind of put a lot of emphasis on, it would be looking at those exact match links with a lot of scrutiny to make sure that you're dealing with them appropriately. Manual outreach is the step which follows the link discovery and the link classification. It's where you actually take that step to contact the different webmasters of the websites which are pointing to yours and which are hosting the links which you want to try and remove. So you want to be contacting those webmasters and asking, you know, requesting that they get rid of those links as soon as possible. Sounds like a really simple process. Reality of it is that it can be quite a disheartening process. If you can imagine, a lot of the websites that you'd be contacting, they're probably completely overwhelmed with similar requests from thousands and thousands and thousands of other SEOs across the world. So for that reason, you'll find that their response rate is often pretty low. For example, on our manual outreach activities, we may find that on certain projects, we only have a success rate of 5 to 15% in removing links manually. But it's really key to remember that we're not only trying to remove the links, that's one objective, but we're also trying to build up a really solid case study, which we can later present to Google to say, hey, look at all the efforts we've gone through to try and clean up our act. So for that reason, during that manual outreach process, I suggest keeping like a Google Docs spreadsheet, which lists all of the contact that you've had during this task. So the links that you've tried to remove, the domains that they're coming from, the webmaster's contact details that you used, the dates that you approached that webmaster to try and get the links removed, and I guess even the number of iterations that you went through within that process. That's all going to be really important. So kind of store that very neatly within a Google Docs file. The disavow tool can be accessed in your Google Webmaster Tools account. And essentially the tool is just a way of saying to Google, hey, these links are links which I've tried to remove manually through contacting various webmasters. I've been unsuccessful, but I no longer want you to take them into account when you're looking at my backlink profile. So you can place all of those links into a text file, very simple text file, and you submit them via the disavow tool. There are a couple of tips you could consider when you're doing your disavow file. So I would say just make it really clean, really neat. Give each link which you're disavowing its own line. And you can even include kind of very simple notes as well, just to kind of bring a bit of clarity to your submission. When you're dealing with a manual penalty, you have the opportunity of submitting what's called a reconsideration request. And this is kind of the last step in the process of trying to get rid of that penalty. So once you've submitted your disavow file, the reconsideration request allows you to kind of pitch your case to Google. And it's like your final declaration of saying, look, these are the things which I was doing in the past, which we shouldn't have been doing. And actually, these are the efforts that I've gone to go and kind of clean up the backlink profile of this particular website. So it's kind of your opportunity to talk about the discovery process you went through, how many links you discovered, how you classified those links, the volume or percentage of links which you felt were worth removing, and for whatever reasons you felt they were unnatural. And I also think it's an opportunity to finally make quite clear to Google that your current practices are completely in line with webmaster guidelines, and they're not breaching webmaster guidelines in any way. So the reconsideration request is a really important part of the process. Most importantly though, I think the reconsideration request gives you an opportunity to submit some of that supportive evidence which you would have compiled during the entire process. So we mentioned earlier on that during your manual outreach, when you were contacting individual websites who had referring links to yours, we said that you should keep some kind of spreadsheet or Google Docs file which outlined the extent of your efforts. And that's something which can be included within your reconsideration request. So not only are you kind of declaring that you're now doing things the proper way and the efforts you've gone to clean up your backlink profile, but you're also supporting that with that spreadsheet which details absolutely everything. And a really top tip would be that we go to quite large extents to make sure there's lots of supportive data in there. So not only dates that you contacted them and responses that you got, but we even screen grab some of the email correspondence between ourselves and the various webmasters who we'd be dealing with, just to show the spam team, because it is reviewed by humans, just to demonstrate to the spam team that we really have done as much as we physically can. Once you've submitted your reconsideration request, you're probably going to have to wait a couple of weeks before you hear something. The response time from the spam team varies a little bit. We've had really quick responses of 4 or 5 days sometimes, which is brilliant. It's what everyone wants. But in most scenarios, you have to wait kind of between sort of 3 to 5 weeks to hear back from the spam team as to whether your reconsideration request has been successful or not. And you're going to get a message in your Google Webmaster Tools account, which either says, great, your manual action has been revoked, or you're going to have the disappointing email which says, hey, not quite there yet. You need to try again. So if you've had it revoked, congratulations. And if you haven't, don't worry. You've got to persist. We find that actually you usually have to go through the process 3 or 4 times sometimes in order to get that manual penalty removed. And I would suggest just kind of starting back at your link discovery, seeing what more links you can discover, outreaching to try and manually remove, and then once again compiling and updating your disavow file and submitting a second recon request.